Hello WordPress enthusiast and welcome to our channel. My name is Robert and in this video I will show you how to translate every part of a WordPress blog or website with TranslatePress. Let me clarify some important things before moving on. The site language of WordPress can be changed without any plugin in this drop-down under General Settings. If you switch from English to Spanish, for example, menu elements on your dashboard, as well as things that belong to WordPress on the front end, will switch to Spanish. As you can see on the top bar, Customize is replaced by Personalizar. And if you go to a blog post, you can read Deja un comentario instead of leave a comment in English. That's great. But if you want to further translate your theme and everything on your site, I recommend the TranslatePress plugin, which is free. Just go to Settings and click on TranslatePress, once the plugin is active, obviously. For this video, I will show you how to translate some parts of the free version of Neve, which is our WordPress theme, but keep in mind that TranslatePress works with any other theme out there. As a first step, you would select the default language in the General Settings tab, which is English in my case. Select another language in this drop-down, let's say Spanish, and click Add. For more languages, just keep selecting them in the drop-down and click Add. If you want to display languages in their native names, select Yes in this drop-down, which will display Espanol instead of Spanish in the language selector, as you can see here. Then say yes if you want to use a subdirectory for the default language. Pick the way you want your language switcher to look when using a shortcode, and separately when using it in your navigation menu. If you want to display a floating language selector, keep this box checked and select the way it looks as well as the place on your website. I don't see separate settings for mobile and desktop, so I think it would be awesome if the developers will think to add such features in the future updates. Click Save Changes once you finish picking your preferred settings above, then go to the Automatic Translation tab and enable this feature to minimize translation costs. Each untranslated string is automatically translated only once, then stored in the database. Cool. You can use the add-ons for SEO, multiple languages, as well as automatic user language detection, which could be a user experience upgrade. The license tab is where you activate the pro add-ons mentioned earlier, and in the Advanced tab, you can fix missing content, disable dynamic translation, and add some filters or generate automatically translated flags. Also, you can exclude specific pieces of content from translating by adding them to these fields. That's it. We are done with the settings, so we can go ahead and translate our WordPress theme. To do that, we need to click on Translate Site over here and wait for the Visual Translator to open. Now you can select the language and string to translate. An extraordinary thing, in my opinion, is that you can upload translated versions of the images you use. To make sure you won't miss anything, use the Next button over here to jump to the next string. The string Translate WordPress is the title of my demo website and Translate Press Review is the subtitle. I would like to see the name of the item here instead of just text. It could be a great way to know exactly what I am editing. Furthermore, if I go to the blog, I can translate every piece of my content, including the read more text, post, buy, and so on. To easily find what you want to translate, just click on the pencil icon near that string. Once everything is translated, you can use the language selector below to switch from English to Spanish. And if you need a language selector in your menu, head over to the menu settings and select what you want to add. Save the menu and then go to the front end and check it out. If you turn on the automatic translation and want to use the Google Translate V2 engine, you need an API key. As an alternative, you can use DeepL automatic translation if you don't want to translate everything manually. So, with TranslatePress, you can easily translate every visible part on your WordPress website, which is the most important thing for multilingual web content. WooCommerce content like products, pages, and checkout can be translated too. Basically, you just need to navigate to the page you want to edit after starting the Translate Site feature of TranslatePress. The home page on my website is made with Elementor, and it is the original demo of Neve you can import from the site library. So, these text elements are made with Elementor, and you can visually translate everything, piece by piece. Let me use Google Translate to see what is web design in Spanish. Diseño web. I will copy the text and paste it in the Spanish field, even if I am not sure it is 100% correct, just to see how it works after I save the translation. Now, if I visit the site and go to that section, if I switch from English to Spanish, that piece of content is shown in Spanish, which is great. That's it for today, guys. If you have questions, please leave a comment below and let me know what is the next WordPress thing you want to see in my videos. Keep up the good work and see you in the next video. Cheers!